Hello everyone. Today for my 400th video, we're taking a look at a very special and unique worm. It's called Bumerang. Now as you can tell by the pretty busy screen we have here, it is a network worm, so we have six Windows 98 second edition virtual machines networked together. As you can see in the network neighborhood, we can view all the other computers, we can look at files on their disks. The disks are configured for full writing and reading access. So, pretty poor security measures, but it helps the worm to spread. So, that's why we're doing this. So, go ahead and run the worm. You'll notice, before we run it, we have a 27,140 byte executable. Now, this worm is different from most file infecting viruses. Most viruses keep the host file intact, but however, when Bumerang arrives on a system, you'll see it loads for a little while, and begins compiling its code base and infecting other files. If you look at the file again, it's shrunk. The worm actually extracts its code from its host file and then just leaves the host file and infects other files from there. So when you try to run it again, it's not a valid application. So it might make it a little bit difficult to pinpoint the worm's true origin point. However, oh, wrong folder. If we look in the Windows system directory, we can see the worm's file. It drops its code into a DLL file called ddraw32.dll. ddraw16 is a legitimate file, so is ddraw.vxd. However, this is the worm's file. You can see 23,000 bytes. So from this file, the worm will infect the other network PCs after about 4 minutes of waiting. Now this worm is also a stealth worm in that it hides its registry key by deleting it if you ever try to run regedit. So it's pretty good at hiding its process. However, even under Task Manager, you can't see it. So we'll give it about 4 minutes and then we'll see that it has infected the other files. Alright, it's been a few minutes now, so we'll go ahead and see if the worm has actually propagated over the network. Look in the Windows directory for all these virtual machines. We should see the ddraw32 file, if it has begun its spreading routine. And yep, there it is, right there in the system directory. So, check the last machine in the list here. Oh, I think this doesn't have the view settings right. There we go. Okay, now we should be able to see it. There it is. So the worm has infected all six of these virtual machines. And as you can see, the normal user wouldn't have show all files checked. So he would probably overlook the worm and not notice it. It's not very noticeable. Files will grow as they are infected, however, their operation isn't changed. And it's really hard to notice, especially because of the stealth components that it has. So what makes Bumerang unique is its awesome payload, which is actually a modified version of the CIH virus. Now, CIH came out in the late 90s, and what it did was on April 26th, it would basically destroy the file allocation table of the hard drive, and then it would, on certain Intel chipsets, would flash the BIOS, the basic input output system. Now, what this means is that it would overwrite the code in the basic input output system, and this contained instructions on how the computer should boot and what order it should follow when booting, and this would often lead computers being unbootable, and they'd really have to be serviced by a technician, as it was pretty much impossible to boot from a bad BIOS back in the 90s. So Bumerang contains a stripped down version which takes away the activation date of April 26th and activates a few years after the file or PC is infected. However, it doesn't just happen on one of the PCs. It does it on all of them, which is insanely badass. So, we're gonna go ahead and set the date to the future on this PC right here. Set it to 2012, why not? Today's date. Alright. And the worm will activate after about 4 minutes, and it will send a signal to all the other virtual machines, or machines on the network rather, to activate their CIH payload immediately. So we'll go ahead and take a break and see that in just a little bit. Alright, we should be seeing soon the payload activating, usually from just accessing a random infected file on the computer. Everything seems to be running fine for now, but in a minute or so, everything should start to fall apart. Might see one of the machines just blue screen as the worm drops the CIH payload, so just have to keep checking out. Change the background. Let's see, how do you do that on Windows 98? Oh, first tab, of course. Now, bubbles is the greatest background ever, and if you disagree, then you are wrong. So, should see the payload soon. Oh, there we go. Oh, crap, there it goes. You see two of the computers. Now, trying to access anything on these other ones should also cause this to happen. Yeah, here we go. Internet Explorer, blue screen. Can we play a game of solitaire? Oh, maybe it doesn't like that. Can we do anything? It's lagging. It's lagging really badly. I need to make one last calculation on my last PC in my network. No! Blue screen. So as you can see, all of these computers have had the CIH payload occur. So, attempting to get past it, you get multiple blue screens. Now it appears to be frozen at this black screen. They all seem to want to do that. And if you try to reboot on the virtual machine, it will lag horrendously. There we go. And it'll check out the normal stuff. Since this BIOS isn't the type that was affected, the BIOS isn't wiped, but the hard drive is pretty much dead. As you can see, if it ever boots up. Yeah, there we go. It's looking for a boot device right now, so these Bumerang virus slash worm hybrid is just insanely destructive. I mean, PCs back in the day could easily go for $1,800, $1,900 for a low to mid-end machine. Never mind a gaming machine, and every computer on your network is wiped out in one instant. So yeah, this worm is awesome. However, you really wouldn't have wanted to get this back in the day. So that's about it for the Bumerang worm video and my 400th video, and thanks to all of you guys for helping me get this far. It's been an honor having you all like my video so much. So thank you. Hope you enjoyed it.